Testing 1 2 3, ya tú sabes, we out here, Jenny Scarlett collaboration. Yeah. My name is Scarlett Estelle. I am the head of membership at Rec Philly's Free Thinkers membership program. My style for the most part is pretty all over the place. I usually like to dress like I'm a Missy Elliott music video reject. So that's definitely the aesthetic I go for, which is pretty sporty, functional, but I definitely do like to glam it up when possible. I think it's just the unapologetic colors. Like, I think like back when like Missy was just doing her thing, I mean, she still is, it was just kind of like this burst of colors, even like with like the textures and like how big and like loud it was. And I think Missy just like really taught me to just be a really open and loud person. I mean, don't get me wrong, I was definitely like an emo kid, so I wore a lot of black like as a teenager, but like now I've been able to incorporate black with like a bit more sports gear and just like loudness with like some accent jerseys that I have here that I really like to wear, and just keeping it fresh. Yo soy de la República Dominicana, Mocana, de Santiago también. Saludos. The Caribbean culture is very colorful and just very vibrant, and I think that every day that I give a pop of color, or I give a splash of just something that's innovative, I'm giving, you know, a shout out to, you know, my Caribbean roots and the people that live there. Early college years, I definitely thought I was like in Mr. Rogers' neighborhood. Like, it was a lot of like big sweaters and like cardigans, and like for some reason I went through like this whole phase of like shorts and like thigh-high socks. I don't know what was happening there, but like I think it was like my rite of passage into being like, something's gotta give. Oh, I was 100% a Tumblr kid, so it was like, oh, that outfit, I could totally rock it. You know what I mean? And I totally couldn't, but I did anyway. I think the game changers are the people themselves. I think we're really just breaking away from, in general, just having like one notion of what fashion is for men or, you know, women. You know, I've always been super unisex, and especially now more than ever, you're gonna super see a lot of stuff that either a guy or a girl could wear. And I think that, you know, it's been this inspiration from, you know, the internet, just having these game-changing people be so accessible that just inspire me to use places like Poshmark to find cooler pieces. And just, again, the gender fluidity of clothing now is gonna just be a huge asset to just accessibility for people who are not even non-binary for the first time, or, you know, non-binary and, you know, don't think that they fit in female or male clothing. And I think that, you know, clothing in general should be like that, because anybody should feel comfortable and feel represented in their clothing. And obviously, being a plus size woman, like, I just, you know, am super looking forward to just brands being more inclusive. If you don't see yourself represented, represent yourself. I think I grew up just wanting to fit in with, like, you know, the skater kids and the rock kids, and I knew I didn't. I knew it was because of my skin. I knew it was because of where I came from. But I wish that a little younger I could have told myself it's okay just to be you and represent yourself the way that you want to, using whatever clothing you want, whether it's male, female, you know, tight, loose. I think it's important to, if you can't find yourself represented somewhere, to be the one who starts that.